Julie Van Dam, the girl in the house. Hello, online Meg. Good morning. How are you?
We're great, Julie. Please tell us about you, Julie. Man, you've got 22 years of experience. You've been in SA for and doing big things. And big things. Yeah, you're doing big things. So now please let us in and let us into your world, please.
Well, my world, you know, I was young when I arrived in Cape Town. I was 27. I come from a background that's very organized in media and business. So the side of my dad is very business oriented, very cultured. My childhood was very positive. So we went to a lot of theaters and museums and all of that. So I come from a media world, and some of my cousins, they own a platform in Belgium for media and TV. And some of them are very creative architects. So, you know, it's like a whole mengelmoes of everything. Mengelmoes means like a mixture. And I arrived here when I was 27, again, with 2,000 rand in my pocket. I had no idea. My parents were crying. They thought, oh no, she's going to South Africa, it's too far. And I started from a driver, from driving clients around, then getting clients from Europe every year. I started from scratch, and I built my imperium when I was 27 on my own. I just went for it. I'm a go-getter, let's say.
Wow. So you got to understand something. Your surname in South Africa means a lot. We love Jean-Claude Van Damme. We love him. From kickboxer all the way Universal Soldier, he's a big superstar this side. Clarify to our audience about, is there confusion? Are we guessing right? What's going on?
You know what's so nice? Wherever I travel in the world, you know, the first thing at customs is they never ask me questions like, you know, what did you do? Where did you come from? Oh, Miss Van Dam. I said, yes, thank you, man. So Van Dam, there's like 18,000 Van Dams. It's like a very common name in Belgium. Yes, sorry, I burst your bubble. And Jean-Claude Van Dam is one of them, but he's not my cousin, no.
Thank you for clarifying that. Thank you for clarifying that.
Are you welcome?
Yeah, so you're a hard worker, man. And in SA, as we all know, the whole social media thing is booming. People want to be social influencers. Please, if you have to burst the bubble, burst it, but give us some insight into how to use this platform of social media.
Well, today, as we know, not today, but let's say the last 15 years, it's all about creating incredible content. It's all about content. And also because we are on Instagram quite a bit, and it's very important to be on Instagram because you can sell, or you can talk about your journey, your story. Every person on this planet has a story to tell. But let it be uplifting, you know, let it be creative. Let it be like fight against all the racial issues. We are one human. No matter if you white, yellow, pink, orange, if you want to wear your hair blue, whatever, let be, let live. And us in the film industry, we're all about, you know, self-expression and be unique, be yourself. So it's all about creating very creative content. And as you see on Instagram, you need a lot of new feeds, you know, new images, new footage. So it's important, you know, that that people see creative stuff, especially with all this pandemic going on worldwide. A lot of the countries in Europe are in lockdown, so they do work from home, but they don't really shoot on location. So that's why they can come to Cape Town now, because you're allowed to fly to Cape Town on business, and we've got all the covered protocols in place on set. So we are quite, I mean, Cape Town is number one production service in the world. We are so experienced and so professional. Our crew, our directors, our editors, our photographers, our models, our talent. I can go the catering, the drivers, everyone. You know, it is incredible. And on our sets as well, everything is we're very mindful. So I always tell to my crew and everyone to bring their own water bottle. So we refill it on set. Less plastic, much better. And also our catering is all recycled. Everything is in recycling boxes. Everything is thought of.
That's amazing. And then as a woman starting out in this in the industry, it's never easy anyway, you know, whichever field we might think of, you know. So tell us about your experience in the film industry, starting out, owning your own business, and just, you know, being a big dog amongst the sharks and stuff.
I tell you, I'm fortunate that I came from Europe. I was born in Brooklyn, New York. So my parents, when they were young, they went to New York. My daddy was a good student. He finished university in Berkeley. And my mom was young, but pregnant, and there I was. So I was born in New York, Brooklyn, and I got an American passport. Yoo-hoo! But I'm Belgian. My parents are from Belgium. So I was born in New York, Brooklyn. I was raised in Antwerp, Belgium. And then I was educated in Amsterdam before I came to South Africa. And, you know, it's very, very important. I have a very, very wise family. That means they uplift us no matter what we did in our teenage years or when we were older. You know, they were always there. They never put us in boxes. We were very free to express. I had the same education as my brothers. So I have two brothers. And my brothers as well, you know, we have hours that we talk, that we uplift each other. We went through the difficult times, the hard times. And it's all about, to be wise with your children, you know, and don't, if your child wants to become an actor, let it be, you know, like motivate him to be a good actor, the best actor, because you can be anything you want. And my father from the beginning, he told us, you know, whatever you do in life, I'm here for you, I love you, and you can do anything you want. So I'm a go-getter. How many times they knocked the door in front of my face, you know, I just kept on opening it and I didn't stop. For me, a no is a yes. And I'm very, I like challenge. Yeah, I like challenge. Challenge me.
I like the attitude. The attitude is very positive and it's rubbing off on me. So appreciate that. Tell us more about your vision. You got as a businesswoman, you got a vision. You want to see your business flourish, and you want to see the standards being elevated in your type of fashion, your style. Let us into that vision.
Well, my vision, being in South Africa and working with top talent, we have incredible fashion designers, but incredible. And every time when I go to Belgium, and Belgium, don't forget, is also very high on the fashion design. And, you know, they always ask me, like, what are you wearing? I mean, I said, sorry, this is South African. This is local. Wow, really? I said, yes, really. So, you know, I'm very conscious about the fashion designers here. And if you look at my work on my Instagram, you can see all the shoots we do with local fashion designers. And I mean, in Europe, in New York, I get so many compliments worldwide about the fashion and also the contemporary art. I'm a fan of contemporary art, and you've got so many good artists in South Africa, contemporary art, any art. And I'm one of the starters of the Mocha Sides, meaning I'm on the wall. If you come to the waterfront V&A and you go to the Contemporary Art Museum and you look on the wall at the entrance, you can see my name, Julie Van Dam. And why is that? Because I contributed in the beginning, and I have a passion for contemporary art. It's in my family, and it uplifts me. Fashion, art, and South Africa is full of it. Full of it. It's a pity there's not enough exposure, because if you would take the same talent that we have in South Africa, in America, you would have been a Kanye West. You know what I'm saying?
Oh wow, that's amazing!
Oh yes, yeah.
Okay, I don't know. Also, so we just lack like proper infrastructure.
It's not only the infrastructure; it's just also a lot of South Africans. I feel it's what I think after all these years living here. They are shy and they're not sure. They are insecure. They're very insecure and they think they're not good enough. And I'm like, what? You create something so magic and so beautiful. That me, being Belgian, I can't wait to wear your latest collection or show it to the world or whatever. I'm proud. I'm Belgian, but I'm also a proudly South African brand now. That's what I am. And also the culture. I love the culture. It's mixed. It's uplifting. You see the youth sharing each other's stories, filmmaking, I mean, it's uplifting. So I'm a complete non-racist human being on this planet. I love everyone. And yes, it's very creative. And especially Cape Town is super creative.
Your energy is amazing. let's talk about your passion about contemporary art. When did it start, and how far? Is it fair to ask how far along has it come, or does that question make sense?
It does make sense. It comes from my father. When we were young kids, again, I was very privileged. So we traveled the world, and because I was born in Brooklyn, my dad took me often to America, and in every city, LA, New York, wherever we went to the contemporary art galleries. And that's where it started. My eyes were like popped out. And then my brother is a passionate contemporary art dealer, art buyer. So, you know, it's in the family, and it's a passion. It's incredible. I love it. And I'm so proud that we have a contemporary art gallery, Mocha Sites in Cape Town, which is the biggest in Africa, not South Africa, in Africa, for contemporary art. It's the Sites Mocha. And I just contributed because I bought one of the pieces in the beginning. And I just love it. It's uplifting. It's educational for the youngsters. There's so much more than just like fashion on Instagram. You know, art is very, very important. It's all about culture.
And how do you use art to communicate your feelings?
For me, when you come and visit my house one day, and you're more than welcome, so this is online worldwide, you can see my whole house is contemporary. So I will tell you, every single piece is with my heart. I bought it with my heart. So you buy something with your heart, first of all, and I just love it. My art comes alive when I sell it or I talk about it. So I just love it. Come to my house.
And the fashion also is an extension of yourself, hey?
The fashion part is also because we do a lot of fashion commercials and fashion shoots. And also coming from Belgium, you know, Belgium and especially Antwerp, we have a lot of young designers because the big fashion academy is there in Antwerp. So you have Anne de Meulemeester, Dries van Noortes, all big names in Europe. And they all come from there. You've got a lot of young designers as well in Antwerp. So, you know, it's a lot of creativity in Antwerp. So yes, it's all about fashion. When you walk the streets, everybody's like making an effort to feel good, you know? And it doesn't cost money to make something yourself. The most creative people are reusing the old collections to make new collections. So I don't like people that throw away and only wear something once. No, be creative, reuse it, make it something different. You know, every time it has a new story, whatever you wear has a story. My dress today has a story. I'm on your platform and I love it. So everything in life has a story.
We are grateful that you thought of us when you wore that dress. let's talk about film and your passion for film. When did it start, and was it your way of kind of like telling your story and contributing to contemporary art as you love it?
Well, when I was a teenager, so I lived in Antwerp as a teenager. And then I said to my parents, I would love to go to Amsterdam to study, you know, Amsterdam in the Netherlands. And I went to a media school. It's a school for PR and media. And there, your degree, you can choose film and photography, which I did. So I finished my degree. It's called the New School in Amsterdam, an amazing school. And we had to do certain projects, art projects. So there again, the art comes in as a student. And also to work with a team, there again. I mean, my success is based on my team. With everything I do, it's my team. My team is my structure, is my bone. Be humble with everybody on set. Otherwise, you know, if there's one bad apple, the rest will crumble. So, you know, again, back to my youth, I studied in Amsterdam. And then I had to finish my degree by working in a TV media company. And that was for 6 months. I worked at Joop van den Ende Productions. And Joop van den Ende Productions is the biggest one today. Today, they call them Endemol Productions. They did Big Brother, all these things. It's all the co-productions that all originate from Joop van den Ende and John de Mol. So my trainee was there. So every day as a young girl, when I arrived, all these actresses and famous people were there, and they were on the same cantina eating the same sandwich as me. And we were all talking, you know, and I'm a talker. And it was so amazing. And I was, my job was to do the right call sheets and to bring all the schedules. So I started scheduling then. That's partly my job today, you know. I need to do the call sheets and the logistics and, you know, the budgets. So it all started there already. And yeah, every morning I saw those big sets and there was a live audience, which I loved, the live audience, and the energy on sets and the people and their stories. And yeah, there I was sold. I loved media. And I was sold. I said, one day I'm going to produce, and I did it.
Now, with somebody that has an overview of the film industry worldwide, because you have your finger on the pulse, how has the pandemic affected the film industry?
Well, the pandemic, of course, affects the whole world. And we got very creative. We had a lot of Zoom calls, like we would tell the hair and makeup how to do her hair, how the makeup, you know, we would art direct from Zoom with the styling. We would have clients being on Zoom with us while our local directors and photographers are doing the job here in Cape Town. So life continues and we shot incredible commercials and they're all on my Instagram. We just get creative. We have a covert sheriff on set, like a covert officer. And she'll hear, they take care of the covert protocols. So, you know, you need to fill in a huge form every day. Your temperature gets checked, there's sanitizer everywhere. We also sanitize the locations. We have a team of people that come in that sanitize the furniture, the equipment, everything is sanitized every single day. In the morning before we start shooting and when we finish, and then again in the morning. So everything gets sanitized and it works. And we just continue and stay creative. Yeah, we created some magic during this pandemic, I have to say.
I believe you. Because I see you, you got the eye. You got the eye for art. you left Belgium. Did you come straight to South Africa? Or did you first like start elsewhere and then settled in South Africa?
So I was raised in Belgium as a teenager. And then after that, I went to Amsterdam to study. And after Amsterdam, I came to Cape Town. And in Cape Town, I was only 27, no idea. I had 2,000 rand in my pocket. I met the right people and I just went for it. I had no answers, but I knew that they were looking for European producers. Why? Because I was the one that had to go to Europe and to get the clients to advertise Cape Town for their film destination. Like for me, it was easy because Cape Town's got everything. There's no, coming from Europe, there's no jet lag. We've got all the locations here. We've got the best catering in the world. I have to say, our food is like, oh, you can't beat this food. I mean, our catering is incredible. And of course, our directors and photographers, our crew members, the lighting, the technicians, set builders. We work a lot with wild animals as well. So we work with a lot of animal wranglers. I have to say, in South Africa, we've got it all. I mean, it's an incredible film destination. And hardworking people, I have to say, very hard.
Amazing, amazing. Now, let's dabble in your personal life. Now, you're a mother of young children. How has your days been affected by, of course, like this mayhem? Can we just call it mayhem? This pandemic has just been crazy.
Well, I've got two daughters, 8 and 9, and I'm lucky, but so lucky. I've got a hands-on husband who loves also, his passionate filmmaker and a passionate surfer, and he cooks. So, and he did the homeschooling with my kids during lockdown because I have no patience for that homeschooling. And I'm just lucky to have him because he's just hands-on and he's an incredible father and filmmaker. And hey, listen, this is my interview. No, I'm just joking. And I'm so proud of him. And I am because of him as well. You know, we talk a lot about our shoots. We uplift each other. We work on different sets and different clients. But at the end, you know, we just do our best. Every project is different. Every shoot, we try our best. And that's why we get booked and rebooked. And my children, when I'm on set and my husband is on set, we have an amazing nanny. And our nanny takes care of my children.
Amazing. Amazing when you have a partner that makes parenthood so such a pleasurable journey. Yeah.
Yes.
Let's back to business now. So now, a lot of people want to be content creators, but they don't understand the business side of things. Like, how do you, like, in terms of how do you license rights to a certain channel to use your content and stuff like that, or a publication? Please, like, share some information, because we just want to create content, but we don't know how to make money from that content. You know what I mean? And we don't know how to keep our hands on that content and the ownership that is. Please advise.
It's also very nice to know there is a very big platform in Cape Town, and it's for the youth. And at the moment, I'll put it on my Facebook page and on my Instagram. It's a competition for young filmmakers, and they need to film on their phones or on their tablets. And you know, they can send it to them, and they will give you all the regulations and how they want it and how they don't want it, because every project is different. So it all depends for if you shoot, you can't use brands, you can't, it's a whole list like that. So if there's any questions, you know, I will gladly send them to you. You can always send it to your viewers or listeners, because there's a whole list of yes and no's, you know. It's a lot of red tape as well in our industry.
Okay, because yeah, Dev, that's true. There's a lot of red tape. So now, for instance, Euroconnect, right? Is Euroconnection or Euroconnect?
Euroconnection.
So for instance,
as well, Tammy, because Euroconnection is mainly Cape Town, but we're gonna produce in the future in Lisbon as well, in Portugal. I love Portugal as well, because it's a mixed culture. It's Vava Vom. It's got also beautiful locations. And I want to do 6 months Cape Town, 6 months Lisbon. And yeah, South Africans, come. My team will be South African for sure, because I can't live without my team. So I will do that during the winter months here when I'm a little bit quiet. I would go to Lisbon, and then in summer, I'm back here.
Chasing some. So can you talk about royalty rights and license rights?
No, I don't do that. No.
Okay, no royalties problem.
Are, because don't forget, I'm a producer. So I produce anything a client wants. And then the rules and regulations that go to different departments at the ad agencies. But the ad agencies that book me to realize the whole concept.
Okay, I see. And how did you start out? What was your first gig?
Sure. Well, that was also a fashion client from Belgium. It's called Scapa of Scotland. And sounds very Scotland, but it's a Belgian brand, Scapa of Scotland. And it was for billboards, and it was for, you know, for all print media. It's been so long, you know. I did so many amazing shoots for Essex and Heineken, Coca-Cola. I mean, all the big brands actually, you know, I've been part of it in a way. And fashion, well, fashion is of course my passion, but they say fashion is my passion. Now filming is my passion, I have to say. I love it. And working for big brands is fantastic, but also for the new and upcoming brands, I'm so excited. Because, you know, the big brands, of course, they pay your bills, but the small ones, you know, if it's creative, I'm all in. I need to be involved in creative content. I like to be surrounded by creative people, and I am who I am because of the people I surround me with. So I want really creative people. And a lot of the times they don't have funds, which is, it's all over the world the same, not only South Africa. They don't have funds, but we do, you know, if it's a creative person, I will push that creative person in the right direction, because that's where I started as well. I also arrived in Cape Town with 2,000 rand, and I'm still here.
It's true indeed. True indeed. Yeah, the smaller brands, there's a lot of creative space. The big brands, there's uh-huh. Small creative space. They're strict on that. Hey.
Exactly.
So now... okay, hey, there's a lot we can talk about with you, because I'm a photographer myself, so I can relate to you when it comes to passion for fashion and stuff. So okay, I think because of time, we also have to wrap it up. Inspiration, of course, everything, that's the number one quality in the universe, inspiration. If you're inspired, you are motivated. could you please share with our readers and our audience who are going through different difficulties in the industry?
Yeah.
Keep them inspired. The stage is yours.
So when you watch The Octopus Teacher, you know, it was also during his time when he shot that in the Western Cape. You know, a lot of times you go to very difficult times, and it's for every human being. But, you know, if you have a creative mind, and again, you've got a tablet and you've got a phone, or you can just borrow it from a friend, but you've got a story in your head. Every youngster has a story to tell, and break free. Be wise, be wiser than all the people around you. You know, don't try to please people. Don't try to listen and obey too much. I'm sorry. Break free and show that you are different, because there's only one of you. There's not a second Julie. There's not a second you neither. It's only one specimen. So, you know, I have to say there's so many creative people, and in South Africa, they have to really love themselves more. So, you know, they feel more confident. And no means yes. If you feel you can do it, you can do it. Show them different. You do it for yourself at the end. And, you know, when I was 27, I had no idea I would be a film producer and work with the best people in the world. And trust me, I had a lot of difficult clients. But you know what? At the end, it's just a production. And I'm as good as the last production, so I have to give it my all. And that's me. And I started as a driver, as a driver, I started from the bottom, and you know, I worked myself up, because I worked 24 hours, because my passion, I'm not a lazy person. And that's what I'm gonna say, don't be lazy, be active. And it's not about money. You have to be creative, you have to put it together and tell your stories and try to uplift stories, because to tell sad stories, and I know we're living in a very difficult world at the time, now with the pandemic, even before the pandemic, racial issues, nature issues. It's always humans. Humans destroy a lot. So, you know, it would be nice if people really stop this nonsense, stop this shit, and just, you know what I mean? Sorry, my English, but just create positivity. Because at the end, we only once here on this planet, just make it happen. Create some magic. That's what we want, magic. Because a lot of kids, you know, are not grown up with magic, and they're grown up in misery. Break out, break free from there, break away. Don't look back, just move forward. That's it. Don't stay in that bubble, get out. Hi, my name is Julie van Damme, a film producer based in Cape Town. Thank you for having me on Online Mag. It was amazing. Thank you, ciao.